Show you something.
Now, we're not going back to that restaurant, are we?
No. Brother Hill, what do you see?
I see a grocery store. What do you see?
I see a whole mess of Negro dollars going into white pockets. Now, look at that. They'll take our money, but they despise us so much, they will not touch our hands in the exchange. Money is power, Brother Hill.
You ain't lying.
Then why are we turning over our power to people who despise us?
But Dr. Johns, the members of our congregation are professional people. They're not business-oriented.
Yeah, and that's our biggest mistake. Right now, we are only consumers. If we're only consumers, we're parasites. Do you want a definition of perpetual motion? Give the average Negro a Cadillac and tell him to park it on some land that he owns. If gold was discovered in the hottest regions of hell, the whites would be there within a fortnight, mining it for all its wealth. The coloreds would show up 3 weeks later, offering their services as maids and butlers. The thing to do is to get there first. We don't think that way. Just to show you what can be done on a small parcel of land, I grew these at the parsonage. I left the roots and the tops on to prove they are not store-bought. The Bible tells us that a feast is made for laughter, and wine maketh merry, but money answereth all things. Now, what does that mean? It means that whoever controls the money has all the answers. You get control of the money by producing. Negroes need to own more businesses, and Negroes need to patronize those businesses. By the way, I noticed that some of you were staring at my feet this morning because I had neglected to wear shoestrings. Well, I'll start wearing them when Negro folks start producing them.